Mabel! Say, hey, hey, don't move. If you move there, I'll move you. Mabel, Alpha.
Ross. Eh? Alpha now. I do.
And my day, no day.
Good morning. Oh, good afternoon.
My day, no day. Mabel.
Eh?
Alpha.
Wait here.
You know why I come now, so reason me.
Ross, wait here, Alpha.
I don't understand. You know nothing I ask you for.
Wait till they ask me like this.
Alpha.
Ross, you calm down. You calm down. Wait till what you say, you shock. Wait till happen. Ah. How much are they owe you, sir?
That's small change. Give me
a. How much?
Eh?
How much?
Not 200 naira. Not 200 naira. Come on, 200 naira. You don't pay me. I better give me.
Yeah, I can't give you. They go. You see that they brush my mouth. You want to call as I brush my mouth? They come. I'll give you.
I don't want to wait for you, maybe. Mm-hmm. I don't want to wait for you.
You're too sharp. So make everybody know say they owe you money. They go. Hope say you get checked for shop. I can't drink another one, no. When you can't let everybody know say I owe you money. Your papa. I can she keep food for me, oh.
Hey, baby. I'm fine. How are you? Sorry, you know how it is now. This area network plus this our WhatsApp call needs stable network. So sorry. Hello. Sorry, baby, I don't know if I heard you well, but did you say that you just bought a house and you want me to go and live in it? Eh? Sorry, hello? Yes, yes, I can hear you. It's the network that is breaking. Okay, yes. Yes, babe, yes. Sorry, where is he located? No, as in the address of the house, so I can go there and check it. Yes, yes. Okay. And you to me, amor, I'm all yours. I love you. I love you, baby. I love you. Oh my gosh, my life don't change. I didn't move Gwen State. Oh God! So you mean I will leave this ghetto? I will come up from this place. Next time you see me, when you see me, say hello, ma'am. Yeah? Hello. Jay! They go take for this area, for this car, baby. And they move Gwen State.
Anybody in this house? Hello?
Hey, what kind of...
Can somebody open this door? Hello?
Hello?
Young man, are you insane? Huh? Why would you leave me standing out here for this long, knocking for that long?
I'm sorry, ma. Is there a problem? Are you the one my yoga said is going to come take over this house?
You should go and ask your generations in the pit of hell that stupid question. What is your problem? Hmm? Open the door, get my things, and let me go inside before I call my fiancé to fire you.
Oh, I'm very sorry, ma. Please don't call him. Please.
Your name again?
John, ma, but you can call me Johnny, as every other person does.
Okay.
Yes, ma.
Come on, you stand up from there. Who gave you a chance to sit down on my fiance's chair? Something wrong with you, huh?
I'm sorry, ma. I just got carried away. The bag was quite heavy when I walked in, so I just said I should sit down and catch my breath.
It is that breath that you're catching that will be your last breath. Mind yourself in this house, so. Mind yourself in this house. You have to be very obedient and respectful so I will not have issues. Do you hear me?
Yes, ma. I promise you, I will be very obedient. I'll be an obedient boy, ma.
Yes.
All right, ma.
Hey, come back. Come. You see, I said it. There is no sense inside this your head. It's block that is inside. Who will carry the bags? Will you take them upstairs?
Okay, ma. Ma, yeah. So, what would you like to have for dinner so that I could just prepare it once I come down? Just prepare it before it's too late.
Mm-hmm. Good boy. Well, you're behaving like someone that actually has sense in his head.
Thank you, ma.
Good. I want potato chips and egg sauce.
Sorry, ma.
Hmm?
We don't have potato here. We have yam. So would you mind if I make yam and egg sauce, ma?
When I spoke just now, did you hear yam come out of my mouth? What did you hear? Don't stress potato. Me.
But ma, I'm sorry, but the problem is that the market is a bit far, and before I'll be able to get there and buy the potato, it will probably be too late for dinner. And you might want to have your dinner quite
John,
early.
I do not care if you have to go to Mass or Katangora Market to go and buy that potatoes, but I want potatoes and egg sauce. Are we clear?
Ma, please, just for tonight, I would get you anything.
Get out of my sight. Hurry up. I don't want to say it again. Get out. Move it! Oh God, I'm in my better days. Don't let me go back to my older days.
Don't try me. I'm sorry, ma.
It's my house! It's my house! Look at that.
Yes, baby. I'm right here. No. The money? Yes, send it to my account.
Oh my God! It's so beautiful.
I have arrived. Ah! Yes, baby. Yes, I'm in the house. And my love, it is so beautiful. Baby, like? What are you saying? Like, I love it. Did you hear me say it's beautiful? Yeah. And I'm all yours too, mi amor. I love you. Have a good day.
Young man, don't tell me you are just coming back since that time.
Ma, I told you. I told you the market is very far and then it gets crowded at evenings.
Why are you always so full of excuses? What is your problem? And I told you before you left this house, I don't like having dinner late. John.
Well then, ma, you should have eaten the yam that I offered now.
Keep quiet. Hold your mouth like this. Hold it. Get to the kitchen and go and make my food for me. Let's not have issues in this house. You know, I've said it 1 million times since I came. This guy is the effrontery. I don't know. It's like that shirt he's wearing, there's audacity inside. Because the fact that he wants to stand and be talking to me like you have right to talk to me in this house. Is this your house?
And where are you going?
Ma, do you need anything? Because I served you, I want to go and eat my food.
If it's not that you are daft, if it's not that there's nothing in your head aside air, are you not supposed to stand here and wait just in case I need anything? What if I choke? What if I need tissue? What if I need something?
Ma, but you have water here.
Shut up!
You have the cutleries.
Keep quiet. You don't talk when I'm talking. It's common logic. When you serve someone, you stand there. Anything could happen, I could faint. Wait here,
please,
let me eat.
I'm very hungry. I want to go and eat my food.
Why do you always like to take me out of character? I'm not this person. Why are you so stupid? Huh? You will stand here and you will wait until I am done eating. Then when I finish, you will not go inside there and make yourself something else to eat, because me and you cannot be sharing food. We're not on the same level now. Look at me, look at you. Do we look alike? No.
Ma, the potato is still remaining. Why do I have to make another?
Are you a thief? Have you ever eaten potatoes in your life before? Hmm? If they tell you to go and buy potatoes now, can you afford it? Shoot. Stand there. I don't even need to know before you whether you poison the food. Hey! I just want salt in the thing like this. Hmm? Yeah, scoop. Yeah, scoop. Nonsense. Nonsense. Yeah. Hi! Jesus. Hi. Just manage it. So it doesn't consider I'm wicked. This is the first time I'm seeing your food. Wait, don't tell me you are still here, still mopping the floor.
Ma, I'm almost done. I'll soon finish.
What you just said now, does it make sense? How does it correlate to what I asked you? Anyways, when you're done, wash these clothes for me.
Ma, sorry. I'm sorry, but Oga Nelson didn't tell me that that is part of my job.
Wait, I am paying you salary. And you want to decide which work you will do and not do in my own house. Are you under a spell? Are you okay?
Ma, this is not about me being okay or not. It's just that Oga Nelson, like I said, didn't tell me to do this. All he just said is I should cook and clean the house. That's all.
I can see that they are after you. They are looking for who will kill you. But let me tell you, it is not me. Are you hearing me? You better respect yourself in this house. Respect yourself. Wash those clothes for me. Don't look for my trouble. Tell me what you do in the house. I'm paying you salary. Ew. God, who is this guy now? Don't tell me you're still here washing these clothes.
I'm almost done. I'm just trying to wash the similar colors together. I'm trying to finish.
What do you mean similar colors? So you will not be able to make me breakfast this morning. Is that what you're saying?
I'm sorry. I'll soon. I'm almost done. I'll finish in a bit.
You're talking of the time that you're using to wash this one as a lap. You're saying you're almost... You have 30 minutes, John. 30 minutes. I'm not a nice person, though. Don't try me. I'm hungry. Come and make me breakfast. Osiso.
Baby girl. How are you now?
Omo, I cannot even explain it because it's so long, but all I can say is your girl has finally left the ghetto! Yes!
Haba, why would you say a thing like that, though?
In fact, you know what? I'll come and visit you in a few hours.
Yes!
I'm a bore. You can never pass on gist, can you?
I've heard. I'll come and see you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. You two talk. Ah!
God, thank you. I didn't know Sinla, so you love me, Rich. Eh? Thank you for taking me out of that smelling, disgusting ghetto. And bringing me into this mansion that is now all my... All my...
But wait, oh. Why has this guy not served my food yet? John! John!
Taking so long to serve my breakfast.
Ma, I'm trying to finish so that I could quickly,
Is it that you have a covenant with excuses? What is the problem? Since I have met you, it is one excuse or the other. You always find something to back up your incompetence, eh?
Ma, I'm trying my best.
You shut up, Ma, before I use this thing to hit you. How dare you talk when I'm talking, hmm? See, I'm giving you 20 minutes. I don't know what you're cooking, but you need to be done. 20 minutes because I need to eat and go see someone. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am. It is food.
What do you mean it is food? I asked you to cook me rice. What is this?
You didn't specify. You said boil rice, make rice. And I made white rice because...
If I did not specify which rice, would you not be sensible? Use the small brain that got deposited like there's like peanuts in your head and come and ask me what kind of rice I want to eat.
Ma, where did I get this wrong? You're the one that asked for rice. And I've done this.
I asked you to make me rice. Let's eat white rice. You're looking for my trouble in this house. You want me to touch you. You want me to actually attack you. What is your problem now? What is it? Take this out of my sight now. Should I pour it on your face? Oh, God. And I'm hungry. John! John!
Yes, ma? I'm here.
Take. Iron those clothes and polish the shoes. I'm going out.
Ma? Please, I just finished making your food and cleaning the place, but I forgot to make enough for myself. So, do you mind if I just make noodles briefly before I do the ironing?
John, get out of my sight.
Okay, to eat.
Yeah, are you insane? I need those clothes ironed and the shoes cleaned because I need to step out. You will not delay me. You will not delay me. Are you hearing me? For your eyes will be smaller than torchlights.
Madam! Madam!
Madam!
Are you blind? Can't you see me here?
I'm sorry, ma.
Why are you screaming? Do you want to bring the building down?
No. I was just calling you to know, let you know that I'm done with the clothes. I'm done ironing it and I'm done polishing this as well.
Hold that one first in one side. Right. And you have tried. Yeah, give me the shoe. John, what is this now? Eh? What did I ask you to do when I gave you the shoes?
You asked me to polish them.
Look at them.
I polished them.
They look polished. If you don't get out for me, get out and go and clean that shoe for me properly. What is your problem? My God, what kind of human being is this now? What is this? Eh? Look at, I don't just want to talk, but look at, is this how human being irons clothes? If I talk now, they'll say my problem is too much. Is this how human being irons clothes, eh? Maybe I'll just wear this one.
Come in. Yeah, I'm coming.
I'm so sorry. Hmm? Why did you leave me standing out there for that long?
I'm sorry, ma. I was cleaning my room and I came as soon as I heard the knock on the door.
You're sure you were cleaning your room and not eating food? Because I know you have a covenant with food.
Why do you like to find fault in everything I do?
I'm sorry.
I was there doing my room and I came as soon as I heard you.
Anyways, that's not the problem right now, babe. Let's go. Baby. Yes. My love, I'm good. How are you? John? John is fine. John is good. I mean, we're getting along really good. Yeah. Baby, come on. You know I'm a good woman, right? Of course I'm a good person. I'm taking good care of him. Yes. Your sister? Oh, she wants to come to the house? Why not? Of course. Does she want to come today? Of course she can come anytime. All right. Baby, are you really going to say bye without my magic words? All right, mi amor, I'm all yours too. I love you. Bye.
Is it more relaxed?
So, I want to... Oh, okay.
Hi, Ma. Ma, I came to ask if there's anything you want me to do for you.
No.
Okay, I'll go and rest then.
You go and what? Come back here. Thinking of it now, I think I have things you need to do. You mop the guest room. In fact, mop all the rooms in the house, aside mine. Mine is still clean, so yeah.
Ma, what's the point mopping the rooms that no one is in? I mean, what's the point? You're just stressing myself unnecessarily.
John, are you not paying me salary in this house? Because I need to understand. I'm giving you orders and you have the authority to flaunt my orders. John, get out of my sight. I can see. Oh no, in fact, it's okay. It's okay. It's fine. Go upstairs, eh? Pack your things and get out of my house.
No, Ma, it hasn't gotten to that. I will mop the rooms.
No, I'll mop it. Come and stand here.
I'm sorry, Ma. Jeez. I'll get the mop and mop the rooms.
You are still looking at me.
No, Ma.
Yes, baby, thank you. I got the money. Yes. I should give 100,000 naira to John. What for? I mean, what does he do that you want to give him that kind of money? By the way, are we not already paying him salary for the work he does in the house? I've heard. No problem, I've heard. Bye. I'm all yours, me amor. Alright, bye. I love you. Give 100,000 naira to John. For what? John! John!
Ma! Yes, madam? Madam.
John, why do you always call my fiancé to stress him out for money?
Ma, I had a very small problem and I called him to see if he could help me with it.
And where you went to go and look for the solution to your problem, you think that he's the cause of your problem, eh? John, you're looking for trouble in this household. Let this be the very last time you will ever call my fiancé to ask him for anything. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
I'll send you 5,000 naira later. Use it to sort out whatever it is. And don't you ever, ever call my fiancé again.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
Go. And come back. Nelson's sister is coming to the house later today. So I need you to go and clean one of those rooms upstairs. And please, please, John, be on your best behavior. Be cool. Let's not show ourselves when she comes. Oh?
Okay, ma.
100,000 naira. Is this so easy to make 100,000 naira in this economy? Thief. Yeah? Hold on. Give me 1 second, I'll be right there. Hi! Come in.
Thank you.
Hello. Imelda, right?
Yes, you're Auntie Marvel.
Yes, it's me. Lovely to meet you.
My brother told me a lot of interesting things about you.
Your brother and always talking about people. Please come in. Oh my God. You can leave that there, that's fine. Wow. let me be here then. Your brother always talking about me, even though he hasn't seen me.
I mean, he doesn't have to meet before he knows you're a kind person.
Right, so let me take you inside so you can see.
Second madam.
Hi.
Good day. Welcome.
Thank you.
Can you see how you're thinking? Did she just enter? Why are you just coming out to greet her?
I wanted you people to finish discussing before I come to greet.
Get out of my sight and go and look for what she will eat. Awesome.
Okay. Your bag.
Nothing.
Yes.
Thank you.
It's okay.
Welcome. Well, how come you don't look anything like your brother, eh?
Are you for real? People always say I resemble my brother a lot.
It's a lie. You too. Take a look at this picture. Do you guys look alike?
Oh, let me just say, he has changed a lot for now.
Oh, well, you make a valid point. Okay, let me take you to your room so you can at least get familiar with it, right?
Okay.
All right, yeah, let's go. I'm such a fine girl. Look at your skin, though. It's as if it's not you that's chopping all the money.
Thank you.
It's this way. Careful.
Yeah, good.
baby girl. You just sit down and be enjoying your life, Loki.
Hi, Auntie Mabel.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Have you eaten?
Not yet.
What do you mean, not yet? John has not served you yet?
Auntie, I believe the food is not ready. He will serve it once he's done cooking.
What is he cooking that is not re- You see, this is the issue I have with this John. He is too lazy and dull for my liking. No, he's just so useless. The only thing he knows how to do is to eat and sleep, as if that is all the problem he has in this life. Eh?
Auntie Mabel, let him be. He will serve the food when he's done cooking.
Believe me when I put it to you that you don't know him more than I know him. I've lived with him for so long to know that if I don't go in there to disturb him, he will not bring that food out. I'm coming.
Ah, Auntie Mabel.
And you.
This feels really nice.
Mm-hmm. Come on. What are you trying to do?
Trying to take the place to the kitchen.
I don't understand. Why would you do a thing like that? What do I have a maid in the house for?
Let me take it to the kitchen to save the poor man the stress.
You want to pity a poor, arrogant man? See that stress you just called? That is exactly what I want that idiot to go through. What am I paying him for? To sit down and be counting the stars? Is that possible? No way. Ah.
It's fine, Auntie Mabel, if you insist.
I insist. I over-insist. John! Come and clear this table for me. Ah, you want to carry what? Don't you know you're the second owner of the house, eh? Ha. John! John.
Ma.
John.
Hmm?
You are here eating. And I've been calling your name inside the house since.
Is there a problem, ma?
I called you since. You did not answer me. You are here eating. And you asked me, is there a problem?
I heard you, ma.
You heard? You're still drinking juice. Leave this food now. Go inside the house and clean the dining.
Ma?
Did I speak Greek? Go inside the house and clean the dining.
Okay. Let me just finish eating, then I'll clean everywhere, ma.
Oh, this boy. John.
Yes, ma?
Leave that food. Go inside the house right now.
Ma, please, let me just finish eating. I'm hungry now.
Will you stand up from there and take... Go inside the house and clean the house for me. Go inside the house. It's because it's not me that I employed you. Are you sure you're okay?
Yes, Auntie, I'm fine.
You don't look fine to me. So, how about you go get dressed and I take you out so we can have some fun?
Auntie, I'm very fine.
I'm not saying you're not fine. You're okay, right? But to make you feel better, let me go and spoil you a little. Go and get dressed. Let's go.
Oh, that's so sweet of you.
You're welcome, babe.
Let me go refresh you now.
All right, love. Books, then it'll be very easy to get the others, you know, his other siblings to like me too. Then when he comes, marriage straight up.
Baby, you get sense.
Baby girl, how are you?
Auntie, you're here.
Yes, so. Sorry I barged into your room just like that. I just wanted to ask you, do you have any shoes, bags that you want to polish?
Yeah.
Or maybe clothes you want to iron?
Yeah, I'll need to iron my clothes and polish my shoes.
Okay, all right then, bring them.
Okay, let me do this.
Nah, let me have it now.
Auntie, you want to iron my clothes for me?
Come on, don't be funny. Why would I want to do that when I have a domestic staff that can actually do that? I pay him for it now. John, let me give him.
No, no. That guy, Johnny, is actually far older than I am. And it won't be nice for me to let him do that.
Who's talking about age here? We're talking about class, and that guy is a nobody. Mm. I pay him to do things like this, so hand it over.
Until leave it.
I'll call your brother. What else do you want to iron?
That's all.
Are you sure?
Yes, please.
The shoes, Uncle.
Until leave it, I'll polish them myself.
Okay. You're sure it's just this one? You will not have a second chance to ask him.
Auntie Mabel.
Hi, my love. Yeah, I'm good. How are you? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know, right? She's been here for like a few hours now. Oh, she's rested. I'm just trying to make her something to eat before we step out to, you know, go check out the city. You know how girls do now. We like to have fun. Yes, my love. Mm-hmm. Do you want to go now? All right, my love. And I'm all yours, too. I love you. Bye.
Wait. Where's this stupid boy? John! John! Because I don't understand why I'm the one in the kitchen doing this cooking now. He's not supposed to be here doing this. John! Where's the plate? Okay. I don't even know anything in this house. It's just so confusing. Don't burn, no.
You look good.
Living the lifestyle.
Oh my God, where is this Johnny guy? See, don't be surprised if I tell you that we'll find this guy eating. I promise you he's eating. John! John! And that's the thing, he acts like he keeps his ears in his pockets.
You should be in there.
John! You see? He's not here. And he doesn't have the decency to tell me that he's going out.
Really?
If I start now, they'll say, maybe your own is too much. What? Responsible human being behave like that.
Let's go.
This adult is my problem that it's too much. I talk too much. I'm a very, very stupid, idiotic, useless fool at his big age.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God. What a day shopping, man.
Well, I sit. Johnny, sit down Johnny.
Now. Yeah.
Yeah. I take.
Eh? Eh? What's going on?
I'm trying to give him some.
Give him. Hey, come back here. Come on, carry this bag and go inside.
Auntie is a human.
What do you mean he's a
human? He deserves to be treated as such.
This thing, this good for nothing. He doesn't deserve anything good in his life. That's why he doesn't have anything good in his life. Don't be doing things like that. So, okay, I took you out to go and shop with my own money. You are shopping for a man. Eh?
Auntie. I really want to thank you for today. I had so much fun. It's been long so spent on me this way.
Anyways. You deserve it, so definitely I have to spend on you.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
The love was really massive.
You're welcome, baby. Yeah. You're welcome.
Oh my God. Baby, I don't know. Maybe I'm okay. I'm fine. You know I'm fine, right? You, how are you?
you want to bring someone else to the house? A lady at that? No. Sure, it's fine. It's okay. Yeah. That's fine, baby. Babe, I also wanted to say thank you for, you know, always seeking my opinion before you make decisions. It makes me feel special. Yeah. And I'm all yours too, mi amor. I love you. Bye.
Ma, I'm sorry, the time you called, I was actually, I was in the bathroom trying to...
And that is why you cannot clean the bathroom in the master's bedroom. When last did you even clean that room, Seth?
I'll go do it.
And what are you doing? No, remove everything, since you want to get dressed in front of me.
Okay.
Anyways, you had a list of my problems right now. What I want to understand is, why does Nelson want to bring somebody else into this house? A woman, for that matter. I hope it's not what I'm thinking. Yeah, that's true. He actually mentioned it to me. He said something about bringing a new help to the house.
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. Okay, he even called me. He told me you guys talked about it already.
Yeah.
That I should look for a very decent and hardworking house help too.
Of course. We do need extra set of hands in this house. But definitely not the female version of that idiot that they call John.
Don't worry, Auntie. I'll get someone that is very responsible and hardworking. Because my brother told me Johnny complained that the work is getting too much for him.
Johnny, come. Wait, how? Your brother never mentioned anything about Johnny complaining. You know what? It's fine. Just look for the help, is all.
Okay, Auntie, let me go dress up. Let's start going.
All right, no problem. All right.
Oh my God. Easy, baby, it's easy.
Give your hand.
Yeah, sure. Oh, I can't believe I'm already missing you.
Oh, I'll miss you too. But the good thing is that I'll be back in the morning.
I can't wait. Make sure you come back on time.
Son is already getting used to me while I've not even stayed for a while.
Of course. I mean, it's just me and that idiot that they call John in this house. And he's about to frustrate the living daylight out of me. So you need to come back home.
Auntie, it's fine. I'll be back tomorrow morning.
All right, baby. Let me walk you to the gate then.
The last time I warned you never to call my fiancé to ask for favors anymore. Did I not?
No, I didn't call him. He was the one that called me.
And you thought in that small head of yours that it was right then that the workload that me I'm giving you is too much. I'm suffering you in this house, right? Is that it? No problem. Once Imelda brings that new girl into this house, consider yourself fired.
No, please. Ma, that's... Please don't fire me now. This is the only work I know how to do. I can't do any other work.
Oh! You did not think about that one when you were opening your mouth and talking that you're tired of workload. You're tired of workload, but you're not tired of the food you eat in this house. As soon as that girl enters this house, you are going to start sharing your food with her. That portion that is making you think you can now raise your chest and call to tell them that workload is too much. Once that new girl comes into this house, you people will start sharing your food together. You want to be fired? Pick one. Will you share your food or will you be fired?
I'll share the food.
Fool. And hey, if you stand up from there, let me come downstairs and I'll meet you there. Idiots.
I thought they say short people that used to be angry like this. What are people with small boobs?
You're Hi, back.
Hi, Auntie.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
Good afternoon.
Hello, good afternoon. How are you? Right.
Auntie, this is Benita, a very hard-working girl I've known for ages. Benita, this is my brother's fiance.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, the one welcome. You're here to serve.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome. So, I do not have any issues. I am a very easygoing person, and I want to believe that you're an easygoing person too, okay? You do your work right, you're respectful, diligent, and you don't stress me, we will live cordially, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
It's not a matter of yes, ma. Because if you start acting like that goat you're going to meet very soon, I will give you a lot of trouble in this house. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
No problem. Nada, take her upstairs.
Okay, okay, auntie.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. What are you trying to do?
Madam, I'm trying to warm food.
You're trying to... Do you even know how to operate a microwave? You see why I call you a village girl?
Madam, it's not about being a village girl. I'm just trying to warm food. I don't know how this thing is.
So you're not talking back at me in my own apartment, in my own house that I hired you to come and work for me. You cannot operate common microwave. And you're telling me you're not a village girl.
I beg, madam, I beg. Don't call me a village girl. My name is Benita. If you want to insult me, insult me. Which one is village girl, local girl? I'm trying to do this thing and the thing is...
Are you talking to me like that in my house?
Madam, madam, don't touch me, oh. Don't touch me. If you touch me, I will touch you back.
You will touch who back? Are you
madam, day or day, oh. Which kind of madam be yourself?
Imelda, where did you get that idiot from?
You mean Benita?
Who else? Where did you get that local, in fact, not even local, timid, idiotic fool from?
Auntie, we're looking for someone that is hardworking. Forget about if she's local or not. Just give her some time, she will come around.
Oh, I hope she lives long enough to come around. Because I asked this fool to do work for me and she's talking back at me in my own house? Really? Where's
Auntie.
John? Where's John?
Auntie.
What is it? Auntie what? Bringing stupid people to come and work for me in my house. Nonsense. John! John, what are you doing here?
Ma, I said I should come here, sit and rest, since we already have someone now that can cook.
Man, she said she can't care, she can't get. She's your dad, show you that. Did you go inside to go and check if she needs assistance? Eh?
What am I checking if she needs assistance? A guy? Yeah. Checking on a. Ma, that sounds absurd. I mean, we already even know she can cook.
Stand up and go and help her in the kitchen. I don't want to turn. I'm going.
Just a bit tired. I wanted to.
Get up, man! Jesus, this boy. You will not kill. You will not kill me in this house. Hey.
Oh my God.
Hey. So when you finish, come and carry my slippers from this neighbor's house. I've thrown it.
That's good. I was actually about to call you to ask you. No, serve.
Okay.
Wait, food is ready.
Okay. How far are you doing upstairs?
I'll be chilling.
And you left me down here. I'm on this show. I don't know. I was watching it and then I just lost interest at some point. American Monster, be something like that. I don't know what that is. Pretty much. Let's go to the dining room. Hey, baby.
Thank you.
All right, enjoy your meal.
Mm-hmm. Where are you going to?
want to go and eat, ma.
I guess that you don't have sense inside that your small head. You see why I call you a village goat?
Madam, please, 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 don't call me a village goat. If you want to correct me, correct me. Which one is village goat? Why are you calling me a village goat now?
You are standing here and talking to... Get out. Get out from... In fact, come and carry this food. I'm not eating. She's asking for me to carry it. What do you mean, Mabel? Did you say the way this... Who did you bring to my house? Look at what she... Look at it. Idiot!
Johnny, I've been looking for you everywhere. I don't know where you are now. I don't like how your madam is treating me. I don't like it.
What did she do?
Because I told her not to call me native foul. She just started hitting me.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Some people can be wicked in this life. At least now you see what I've been going through before you came.
You must have been going through hell, oh. That woman is really, really wicked.
Honestly, I have been going through hell. My only consolation is that I know that when Nelson comes, he will at least change my life.
God, please, oh, let him change my own life too, eh? I just want to work and make money so that I can take care of my sick father, eh? Just that.
Don't worry, stay positive. Everything will be fine when he comes, okay?
Staying positive.
Sit down and eat. I forget your problem.
Are you sure that she will not come and...
Sit down and eat. Do you see me? I've developed a thick skin.
Yeah, I'm tired.
What she does not affect me anymore.
Getting
tired. Eat apple. Forget your problem.
Thank you.
Hey!
Young lady. What are you doing in my living room?
Ma, I was feeling lonely in my room. I couldn't sleep, so I said let me come out and watch something.
And you think sitting in my living room would help you sleep better?
Ma, you know, this is a new environment. I'm still trying to adapt to the new environment. And my room is very lonely. I said if I come outside here and watch a movie for some time, I'll feel sleepy. I'm going to feel sleepy watching movies.
So all the things that just came out of your mouth now, they sounded right in your head. Can you listen to yourself talk? You this low-life smelling... Oh, God. Please get out of my sight now. Before you infect my chair with your nonsense bacteria that you came with, from the village with. Come on, stand from there with your bacteria-infested body. Get out from here!
Ma, I know I'm a nobody, but I'm also a human being. And I know that someday, when there's life, there's hope.
Get out!
Sorry, ma.
Shoot. Just wasting my light and wasting my credit. Do you know how much light costs in Lagos? And keep that. They got all these useless people to come and stay in the house for me. Easy, baby.
Yeah. Oh.
This is your small box. You start to behave, you.
Hi, Benita.
Good.
Well done.
Thank you.
I'll be leaving. Please stay safe with your madam.
Are you, ma?
You will what? You that you've proven yourself to be worse than the other idiot I have in this house. Come on, save up and go and see what you're doing. Let's go, babe. Let me see you off, Jerry. Easy.
Yeah.
You stop with that irritating voice that I'm hearing now. When you're done, look at what you're mopping. Look at how dirty the floor is. When you're done, go and make me rice to eat for breakfast. And hurry up. John, what are you still doing here?
I'm working, ma.
What do you mean working? What are you doing that is taking you so long? Huh?
Ma, I'm sorry, but I'm trying
keep
to fix
keep the explanation in your mouth. Finish this thing now and get out of my sight. Yes?
Madam.
Mm-hmm. Again.
I want to ask, the rice that you asked me to prepare, is it jollof rice or rice and stew or fried rice?
You mean to tell me that since I told you to cook, you have not started?
That's why I came to ask if it's jollof rice or...
Is that what I just asked you just now? Have you started cooking or not?
I'm about to start, ma.
You're about to start, and you have the F1 to stand in front of me. I'm telling you, I'm about to. Ow! Let Maggie me in, Maggie! Idiot!
Oh, God. I'm so. Oh, God. Just. Good for my bitch. HIN. I'm going to. Ozeba, 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 Ozeba,
Ozeba, Ozeba, Ozeba, Ozeba, Ozeba. Always doing something senseless. What are you cooking?
I decided to make jollof rice since you were not specific.
Good. Where's John?
He's outside, ma.
Outside doing what? I asked him to come and assist you. I mean, he's getting paid to work, isn't he?
Well, madam, he's a man. He can't be in this kitchen while I'm cooking, so I told him to go and rest. It's somehow now if I'm here and then he's cooking in this kitchen, I feel that it doesn't make sense to me. So I told him to go and rest.
You're such a timid fool. There's no sense in your head. There are women out there, feminists that are advocating for men to start doing housework, start cooking. You, I gave it to you on a platter of gold. You know, saying he's a man. You're just an idiot. Nothing is in your head. That what?
Madam.
Oh, you're flashing knife at me. Let me step back first because I don't trust you. Evil idiot. Cook this for me and let me eat something for 5 cents. Ewu.
Clear for my way. Clear for my way. Clear for my way.
Sit. Do you? Of course you don't.
You know, looking at you now, you're actually not bad.
I want a massage. In my room.
I'm sorry, Ma, I can't do that. It's not part of my job description.
Well, I'm adding it to your job description. You will give me a massage.
No, you're not the one that paid me my salary.
I could tell the person that pays you not to pay you, realize that, right?
Then I'll say it's because I refuse to give massage.
Wait, you will go and tell him and you actually believe that he will believe you.
Oh, you poor thing.
It's easy. My skin is soft. I have some oil upstairs. You know, maybe a massage with a happy ending.
Where are you going? John. John.
Power belongs to you. Power belongs to you.
You're still here mopping. Is the food ready?
I'm almost done, ma.
What do you mean by you are almost done? Huh? I'm hungry and you're telling me you're almost done.
Well, what do you want me to say again? I said I'm almost done.
Hey, God, I'm trying to understand. You're raising voice, so you're talking to me. Let's say you don't pay me salary for this house because I don't understand. I asked John to come and assist you in the kitchen and you sent him out with your local attitude.
Ma, it's better you allow me to finish cooking and come and serve you in peace. Allow me to breathe now. I don't like the way you're always choking me.
I'm choking you. No, come. No, let me choke
sorry,
you.
Sorry, ma. Sorry. It's like you're mad. I didn't mean to say it.
You need to hurry up with this food because I'm hungry. If I come back into this kitchen again, I'll break your head.
I'm choking you.
Idiot.
Oh.
Melissa?
Yes, ma'am.
You cooked this food?
Yes, ma'am.
In this house?
Yes.
You are sure?
Very sure, ma'am.
And you sweet like this? Huh.
Thank you, ma'am.
Hmm. You made enough, right?
Yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm. No, the one I made, if I give Johnny his own portion, the rest is for me, ma'am.
Scrap that. Make sure nobody touches the food in the pot, okay?
You said what? Ma, you said what?
Did I speak Greek?
But ma, what are we going to have for lunch?
Go upstairs. Left side drawer. You see 1,000 naira there. You and John share it amongst yourselves. Buy donuts. Pay water. Anything you feel like.
Spoil
yourself.
But ma, how are we going to... The rice is still in the pot, especially...
If I knock you, your height will reduce more than it is like this. Come on, get off my sight! Just if you manage to tell that your food is sweet and will not hear what. You are still standing there?
Benita. Benita.
Hmm?
What is going on? It's been a long time since you finished cooking, and yet you've not still served my food.
Here, that's for lunch.
Is this a joke? Does this woman even think that we are human beings at all, does she? What does she think we are? What kind of an evil person is she? Is this who she really is? Eh?
She said we shouldn't touch her food. That we should go and look for something to eat. That's what she said.
She should better be careful, though. Because this little journey that she's despising today might just be a big man tomorrow. What am I supposed to buy with this? Just look at it.
Baby, what?
You mean you're coming into town tomorrow?
So I'm going to see you?
Oh my God! I'm so excited, my love, yes!
Don't worry, I'll take care of everything. I'm just going to go to bed now, wake up tomorrow, and organize everything for your landing. Yes, baby. And as always, I'm all yours too, Mia Moore.
I love you. I can't wait to see you.
And spoil you with kisses. All right, baby.
Bye.
John. John.
Yes.
Okay, so today I'm going to need you to be on your best behavior. Do you understand that? Your best mood also, because my baby boy, Nelson, is coming into town today.
Nelson is coming today?
Did I speak Greek? No.
No.
So you need to be on your best behavior, and you need to go and help Benita in the kitchen make something fast. I want the whole house sparkling clean. Repeat okay. It.
You want the house sparkling clean?
Good.
I'll do my best. I'll just finish up.
Hurry up, please.
All right.
I just want to be...
Benita. Have you finished cooking the food I asked you to cook? Have you finished cooking what I asked you to cook?
Ma, I'm almost done. I'm almost done.
Look, you are almost done. My fiancé is on his way here and he's almost here. And I don't want him to come and there's no food in this house. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am. I'll soon be done. See, I'm just...
Make sure it's delicious. And come close. Ma? Close to me now. Come close. If you ever open your mouth, I tell you that you're the one that cooked it. Am I clear? Eh?
Yes, ma'am. Ma. Madame, please, someone too wicked, though. For drink again.
Oh my God. The sun today is so terrible. Benita.
Yes, he just finished mopping the rooms. I think he's somewhere around mopping.
All right, fine. Are you done what you're doing?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, because Nelson sent his friend to pick up the car to come get him at the airport, so I'm sure they'll be here soon. Oh. So you need to hurry up, please.
Okay, ma'am.
Let me go check on John. John! I hope you're done.
You are what the old Lord. Invincible God.
How far have you gone with what you're doing, Benita?
I'm almost done. I'm
you
just
need to hurry up, please. You're almost here.
Okay, ma. Huh? Ma, what? I think I can hear a horn. Is that not them? I think it's them.
Let me go and check. Hey. Come on, team. Hurry up with what you're doing, please.
Let me save. Go see my old girl. Hey. Make I leave this.
Melda, what's going on here? John? What's happening? Can somebody say something?
Well, I am the Nelson you've been speaking with on the phone. You're shocked, right?
Wait. Johnny, you mean say you be the other way we dey wait for since?
Yes.
What sort of silly joke is this, huh? You think I wouldn't know my fiancé? You think I don't have pictures of him?
Oh, God. Maybelle, I would expect you to be smart.
Excuse you?
Pictures can be deceiving. If you were smart, you would know pictures can be altered and doctored. Come on, anybody can be anybody with a picture. I intentionally made sure that we do not video call. Just left it on audio. It was intentional. And to save you the stress, yes. So I came up with this plan with my friend Fred. All right, because I've seen a lot in the hands of women. They've shown me what you people call shiggy banza. So I decided to know the person that I will spend the rest of my life with. I will put her through this test. I will become a poor person and see how she treats me. And if she does good,
you know.
You, Maybelle, you treated me so poorly.
Oh. You see, that's why. Now I understand why God did not give you money, because it will not fit you. What kind of nonsense joke is this? Where's the camera? Bring it out.
I'm all yours. Mi amor. That's our code, right?
It's you, Nelson. But why did you lie to me?
I already answered. Just save me the stress. I already answered this question, didn't I? You, God, you were terrible. You were terrible to me. You treated me so poorly. This Maybelle of a girl, she's so mean. See the way she's treating me because she thinks I'm poor. So if I get broke and poor tomorrow, this lady will literally kill me. Is this who she is? Maybe I should test her some more to see if she will change. At least, just give her time. Because this is terrible. It's really terrible. My sister called me at some point and said she wanted to come see me, that she had missed her brother. So I told her the situation on ground, and then she agreed to play ball with me. God.
I was good to you, Milda. You were there. I was good to her. I was only evil to the common man.
Common man? You call me a common man? No. Someone that God created. Come on. Oh, God. Yeah, no lies. You were actually very good to my sister. You treated her nicely. But what about the common man? Your attitude to him never ever changed.
I'm sorry, please forgive me.
You're sorry?
Yes.
For what exactly? For treating me like trash? Poorly, heartlessly? Or is it for bringing another man into my house? Or for smoking, had some stunts, drinking, like a riffraff? Or is it for the fake life? Oh yes, my sister told me everything. Other gist, how you helped me and all. Wow.
Maybe I was just joking, it was just a prank. I didn't mean to.
Brother, when is this rubbish going to end? Why condoling this nonsense from Mabel? All in the name of trying to know if she's a good girl.
Relax, I know what I'm doing.
You know nothing here. What rubbish is this? Chase the arrogant girl out already and have some peace in your house.
I'll chase her out, okay? Well, you know she's a very poor girl, so let's just allow her eat, okay?
How will she admit her poverty? Imagine Mabel telling me she's from a rich home, that she's a classy girl, that she was the one who helped you.
Yeah, it's actually funny. You know, she does not know that I know her. Very well. She does not know that I know her down to her family, like deep down, everything. She doesn't know. But it's okay. Like I said, just leave her a bit. I know what I'm doing.
It's fine. Her fake life is making me hate her the more.
I understand. I understand, but don't worry. Just go. Go take care of other things.
Brother.
Okay? I got you, baby. Don't worry. I know what I'm doing. Trust me.
Okay, fine.
All right. You want Mabel to find out?
Let her know, Nami. I'm tired of all this pretense, Abeg. Anyway, she's in her room sleeping. Look, I'm not here to tell you anything. If you don't want to chase that girl, well, I will personally do that myself.
That's not the problem, okay? The problem is actually chasing her out.
What do you mean?
I love her.
Can you hear yourself talk? How can you love someone like Mabel? That ruthless and heartless girl. If you get married to her, that's how she's going to treat you, exact way she's treating you right now. Is that what you want for yourself?
I just believe that if I give her time, she will change.
That girl is not going to change. She won't change. If you don't chase her out, I will do that myself. We have to do something. Really.
I kept waiting and praying to God that you would change.
I'm a good person. I'm a good person, I promise you. I'm sorry. I'll do anything to prove things right, please. You know I'm not a bad person now. You know, I was just evil because he didn't have anything. He wasn't nobody.
Nobody. God, just look at you.
I will change. I'm ready to change. Anything you want me to be, I will be right now. Please, baby, please.
I'm sorry, it's too late for that already. We are done.
Baby,
are you going to... Pack your things and leave my house.
Ha, baby, no, no. Are you really going to leave me for another woman?
Yes. And that woman is... Benita.
Sir?
Yes, Benita. See, while I got done waiting for her to change, I told my sister how done I was, and she suggested you. I've made up my mind. Mabel has to leave. Honestly, she's not in the class of girls that I want to associate with. I need a woman that is compassionate and kind and caring towards people that are around her.
Good. I'm very happy that you finally decided to take this boot step. But I know of a very decent girl in my area. Very decent girl. The only problem is that she's not exposed. And family problem won't let her live life freely.
Hmm. I'll bring her now. What we'll do is we'll disguise her as a maid in the house.
Very good.
Yeah.
Very good.
Just bring her. I'll just have my eyes on her. I'll watch her how she behaves as the maid. How caring she can be, we'll see.
Well, that she's a decent girl, trust me.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. We'll see. Yeah. We'll see. Is it unlike you? Benita is humane. She treats people with respect, with love. She's warm. There was a time you sent me to the kitchen to cook, and she told me no. No, leave it, I'll handle it. A man should be respected and treated with respect. And that day I felt like a man.
I can be all that. I just wanted you to learn how to cook. Please,
baby. It's okay. All right, enough with all the words. I'm done.
Baby, please, I love
please,
you.
Please, leave my
love
house.
You.
It's okay. Leave my house.
Please, I beg you, I beg you.
Benita, please make me that meal you said you were going to make your boyfriend come.
No, I'll make it. I can.
Get out of the house. No. Don't you touch me.
No, you know, Nelson, please. Nelson. Imelda, please, I make you, please. I was good. Imelda. Uncle Fred. Nelson, please, Nelson, I beg you. I can cook. I can clean. I'll do everything. Let me do it now. I'm arranging it, Nelson. I'm arranging it. Nelson, please.
To let me eat alone.
Who am I to eat with my ogre?
I'm not your boss anymore. You're my girl. So please, sit.
Sir, please, just eat your food and allow me to go.
I insist. I say you should sit. Sit, join me. Sit.